Hi Aquarius, my sun sign brothers and sisters, welcome to your week ahead taroscope with me Raphael from Reydiant Reality. It's an absolute pleasure to have you. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for joining me. Quick note, my readings are for your sun, moon and ascendant sign. So whether you're a sun, moon or rising sign Aquarius, this is for you. And I always advise that you watch all three to get a clearer, more complete picture of how they're going to speak to you. With that said, excuse me. Remember, they are general readings. Not everything's going to resonate with everybody, and that is just fine. Don't forget to use your own discernment. Before we start, as always, I would like to bless my deck of cards with all forms of love, light, peace, prosperity, and abundance. And I pray that the messages that come through are ultimately clear and concise, and they help you on your path to your highest vibrational good. So for your key to the week this week, you've got the death card, right? Now, if you're anything like me, that powerful full moon would have hit you hard, right? So whether it's your sun, moon or ascendant sign, that powerful full moon that was at 29 degrees of Aquarius will have really hit you hard. In a lot of ways, it will have done some real good. And in a lot of ways, it will have brought something to a full, finite, complete end. And I feel like this week, it's not necessarily that something is dying this week or ending. This is the week where you have to deal with the aftermath of whatever came to an end. There's a realization here where something has been sealed. It's like it's been laid to rest and now you're pouring the soil on top. That's the feeling that I get from this week, and that's what I kind of feel from that death card. For your foundation, you have the Emperor card. So this is slightly different. The Emperor can represent a father figure and or a grandfather. You add to that the death card. This could literally be, you know, and I touch wood and I truly hope that I'm wrong on this level, but this could be the death of an elder male in the family. It is possible with this combination of cards. Now, another way that this could show up, the death card is number 13, 1 and 3 gives you 4. The Emperor himself is number 4, and both of these cards are ruled by Mars. Why? Because the death card is Scorpio, the traditional ruler of death is of Scorpio is Aries in ancient or Hellenistic astrology, and the Emperor card being Aries can literally represent the Aries energy, which is also ruled by Mars. So this whole week does feel like it's going to have a little bit of an edge to it, where you may feel that you are kind of, I don't know why, it's really weird, but it's almost like you're teetering on the edge of something that is very, very final. It's like you feel like you're at that, you know, you're at the station and you know which train you're taking, you've got your ticket, and it's like you're just waiting with bated breath. Like, once I leave this place, I know I'm not coming back here. And if I ever do, I'm going to be very, very different to who I was previously. This is one of those moments where the self, the life, the lifescape, the life path is coming up for a very big change. And I think this is going to give you a really strong sense, not only of yourself, but where you are headed from here on in. So for those of you that are continued subbies, you know Raffy loves you. And for those of you that are new to my channel, my fellow Aquarians, sun, moon or ascendant, if you should so choose and it resonates, hit that subscribe button and please don't forget to like and share. So for your actions and options this week, sorry, I just forgot to shuffle. For your actions and options this week, we have the Five of Cups, all right? So this coupled with the Death card is one of the few combinations that can mean death. But the really weird thing is this combination is actually the aftermath of death, when something has come to an end. Now, this could be a relationship. Doesn't have to be like your partner or your spouse. This could be a friend. It could be a sibling. It could be a colleague. Some relationship in your life this week has come to an end and you are going through the process of like literally saying to yourself, okay, you know what? This is done now and I have to deal with whatever the aftermath of this happens to be. For your communications and conversations, you've got the Eight of Wands. Now, this is interesting because this suggests that the news of this thing coming to an end may come through a phone call. It may even come as news to you, you know, that comes to you, that is made known to you. The other thing with the Eight of Wands as well, it's usually emails, text messages, phone calls. Communication is going to be very fast this week. And in the sea of information that is happening for you, this might be a part of it. And it's like, okay, there's so much going on right now. How do I process this? How do I deal with this? I'll give you a really, maybe not so, well, it wasn't funny at the time, but it is funny now. I remember one day, this was probably about 10, maybe, probably about 12 years ago now. I was rushing around. I was really late for, I think it was work. I can't remember. I was really late for something and I was rushing around like a crazy person. And you know, like the first step that you take is like all of your power is in that step because it's the one that gets you moving. I was in such a rush that the step that I took to go out of my bathroom, I smacked my little left toe against the door frame. And I literally, like, the snap echoed around the whole bathroom. And I thought, I'm going to know about that. And I was so angry and frustrated already at the time that I literally just said, do you know what? I can't even deal with this right now. So I just went about my day. I continued about my business. I'm laughing now, but at the time, right? So anyway, at first it wasn't so bad. I was like, oh, that's a bit tender. Within 4 hours, I kid you not, like my foot and like was black and it was swollen like a balloon. And obviously it had been exacerbated because I, you know, rather than acknowledge it and say, I need to sort this now, I just kind of ignored it. This could be some information or some news that comes to you this week that you might have to deal with immediately. You might not know how, you might feel that you don't have time, energy, space, or whatever. You have to deal with it, all right? Don't ignore this. You're gonna have to deal with it as and when it comes up. And I feel like this is gonna be quite important. So just something to consider. Now, for those of you that work for somebody else, this may be something that you were promised, a promotion, maybe a job offer. Something is being retracted this week by an employer or a prospective employer. And while at the time it's going to feel like, okay, this is really personal, what have I done, etc., don't get into your mind about it. It's not about you, right? This is actually a blessing in disguise. When it comes to those of you that are business owners, entrepreneurs, solopreneurs that work for themselves, something that you thought was going ahead, something maybe that you'd been promised or assured was going to happen for you, is no longer moving ahead. And I think this is you finding a way. So it's kind of like, you know, like with your lymph system, people that have, you know, gone through traumatic stuff with the lymph system will know this. When they have to cut a piece of it out, your body will build a new pathway for the lymph to travel through. Like, it was just ingenious. It's crazy how amazing that is. This week, whatever avenue is shut down for you, you just have to find a different one. It's not the answer is no, it's just that's not the way. Kind of like a Thomas Edison moment, right? If he even did invent the light bulb. I'm not here to get into all of that, but you get my point. It's not that these are all wrong ways, it's just that these are ways that don't work. There are different ways that don't do what I need it to do, and this might be that. For those of you that are retired or no longer working, especially for those of you that are retired as in, you know, in, you know, coming up to the winter of your lives, etc., this may be news of a passing, and it might come over the phone or as an email, and it might be, you know, you'll feel this. It looks like whoever this person was, you do care for. Now, for your love and relations, you've got the Ace of Wands, right? So all things, good and bad, come in pairs. You know, the sweets come with the sours, as they say. Now, for those of you that are single, this could be that in some of the challenges that shape up for you this week, love, the potential for a relationship or somebody that means something quite special to you could arise this week. And you might not even realize, like, wow, okay, you know what? I am considering this with this person. This is about fun, pleasure, and enjoyment, and finding ways to do that through the connections that you have will be very important. When it comes to your, those of you that are married, you know, in long-term relationships or partnerships. This is actually very nice. And the fact that you've got it here with the Eight of Wands, there can be a lot of really great communication in your interpersonal relationships this week. For some of you, if there has been an interpersonal tie that's come to an end, you're going to realize very quickly that whatever has ended has made space for someone new or for some new connection to come in. So it's not all doom and gloom. There's a lot of good here. There's a lot of great communication, but there is something that will require your immediate attention. And then finally, for your money and materials, you've got the Nine of Swords underneath the Eight of Wands. So when it comes to finances, it's really weird because I see you having to chase money this week. It's not that you don't have it or that there are problems with it, but you're having to chase money. Maybe this is, if you work for yourself, you're chasing an invoice. You know, is there any chance you're going to pay this or like all of that usual rigmarole crap. That might be an issue. It may be for some of you as well that you're considering, okay, if this is happening, what are my plans? There's got to be another plan. There's got to be something else that I'm planning to do outside of this. For some of you, this might be creating a different revenue stream. For some of you, it might even be that you decide to knock one avenue of making money on the head completely. Very, very interesting. For your physical health and vitality, this is going to be your arms, hands, fingers, anything that you use for dexterity and stuff. Like, be careful this week as well if you're rushing around. It won't be your feet, it will be your fingers and your hands. So just watch out for that, all right? You know, we've all done it. Shut our finger in the door, etc. Touch wood, you know, I banish that thought from all of you. It won't befall any of you, as far as I'm concerned. But just please watch out for yourself. And then finally, when it comes to your home and environment, it could get loud this week. And it's got nothing to do with you. This is something that appears to be happening outside of your place. So, you know, whatever it is, maybe this is one of those times where minding your business is going to be, you know, I mean, Aquarian people tend to be quite detached anyway, so I don't really care what's going on out there. I care about people, but I don't really care what's going, you know, on out there. With that said, I wish you an abundance of all of that good stuff. Have a fantastic week. Let me know in the comments how it shapes up. I'm sorry, it looks like a challenging week, but like I said, there are pockets of goodness here. At the same time, it's not all doom and gloom, so don't throw the whole reading out, all right? Take care, and I'll see you soon.